Science is pretty cool stuff. And in this video, I'll be showing you a scientifically validated lactate flushing protocol that you can perform after your leg workouts to help you remove up to 60% more lactic acid from your leg muscles. Now, the result will be noticeably reduced post-workout muscle soreness and a much faster overall recovery, which means less downtime required before your next training session. Now, this is really cool stuff, so let's get right into it. How's it going, everyone? All right, we are tapping into the world of exercise physiology in this video, which is the study of the body's responses to physical activity. So if you're not aware, muscles can become stiff and sore either during a workout or following a bout of strenuous exercise. And the type that we're focusing on here is muscle soreness that rears its ugly head between 24 to 72 hours after a workout. Now, it's known as delayed onset muscle soreness, or DOMS for short. It's a normal phenomenon, and the intensity of it is dictated by a few different factors, notably how hard your muscles work during an activity session. Now, the harder they work, the more DOMS you'll typically experience. It's also largely dictated by how conditioned your muscles are to begin with. Now, the less conditioned or in shape they are, the more soreness they will typically experience following a workout. Now, the soreness and subsequent stiffness we often feel in our muscles when experiencing DOMS is ultimately from a bunch of metabolic processes that have taken place within the muscles when they were exercised. And while I'm not going to get into the geeky metabolic pathways and the really hardcore details for what specifically goes on, it's worth knowing that the soreness and stiffness is the result of a pH disruption due to the buildup of hydrogen ions within your muscles. Now, this in turn ends in the metabolic byproduct known as lactic acid. Now, that could be seen as a bit of an overly simplistic explanation, but the take-home message is that the more of this junk that you have sitting around in your muscles after a workout, the stiffer and more sore they will feel. Hence, if we can flush out this metabolic junk, our muscles will recover much faster and feel back to normal at a noticeably increased rate. So there are numerous ways to help promote the removal of lactic acid following an intense workout. Now, all of them can be beneficial, and while someone like me might use multiple interventions for my patients in the clinic or my athletes in the gym, the best one is also the most accessible one for most individuals. For the average athlete or active individual, we're going to capitalize on equipment practicality and utilization of the skeletal muscle pump to our benefit. Now, the skeletal muscle pump refers to forcing blood to move within the body by repeatedly contracting and relaxing our muscles. Now, if you get your heart rate up while doing this, it's like a transmission flush for your vehicle. You're getting out all the nasty stuff and you're bringing the good stuff in. The key is that we flush out the maximal amount possible immediately after the workout. The longer we go with letting all this metabolic junk sit within the muscles, the less effective the flushing protocol will be. And hey, real quick, if you're finding any of this video to be useful, helpful, or informative, or just overall enjoyable, feel free to hit that like button because that would mean a lot to me. So there are numerous protocols that exist for doing this, and the one that we're running through here comes from a 1998 study by Martin et al., whereby they performed a lactic acid flushing protocol using a traditional stationary exercise bike. And they had subjects perform 20 minutes of pedaling at 80 RPMs with enough of a resistance on the bike to take them to 40% of their VO2 max. Now, this protocol produced a 60% greater amount of lactic acid removal than subjects who just sat still after their lower body workout. Now, VO2 max refers to the maximum amount of oxygen that your body can take in and utilize while exercising. And while you might not know what your VO2 max is, I've got a workaround that will help you get well within the ballpark. The easiest way to do this is to pedal at 80 RPMs with enough resistance to elevate and sustain your heart rate at around 60% of its maximal rate. To find this number, you can do a quick calculation to ballpark your estimated maximum rate. So use this formula that I've got up here on the screen to find your estimated maximum. Then multiply this number by 0.6 to get 60% of your maximal heart rate. As an example, with me being 38 years old, my estimated maximal heart rate is 182 beats per minute, and 60% of this maximum would put me at 109 beats per minute. And this is the approximate rate I would try to stay at through the 20 minutes of pedaling. Now, to monitor your heart rate to ensure that you're staying at the right intensity, you can either wear a heart rate monitor or by pedaling at what feels like a 6 out of 10 intensity. Obviously, a heart rate monitor will be more accurate. However, the practicality of this for the average person isn't justifiable. So estimating your intensity to feel like a 6 out of 10 is likely your best bet. And this intensity should only feel mildly taxing. It should take a bit of effort, but it shouldn't be exhausting or overly strenuous by any means. Anecdotally, I will say that this protocol works quite well for me. And spending 20 minutes on a bike to drastically speed up muscle recovery over the following days, for me, it's a no-brainer. Now, the quicker I'm recovered and the quicker I can get another activity session in, the happier I am. Besides, some light conditioning helps burn a few extra calories. Now, if you find any of this video to be helpful or useful, then you may want to consider subscribing to this channel, as I am getting ready to drop a whole new bunch of content regarding the latest scientific findings with training, workout recovery, injury prevention, injury recovery, and a whole lot more. So if any of this interests you, I'd encourage you to subscribe so you can stay up to speed regarding all the content that I'm putting out. All right, everyone, stay passionate and stay hungry. And as always, keep looking after yourselves, keep looking after one another, keep making great things happen, and I'll see you in the next video.